Welcome to evening prayers for Monday, the 24th of January. Our theme for this evening is defeating our pride. We're going to begin our prayers with a reading from Paul's first letter to the church at Corinth. This was a church which was faithful to God and passionate in their faith, but one of the big issues they carried amongst them was the need that each person felt to be better and holier than all of the other people worshipping around them. In this part of the letter we're about to hear, Paul is talking to them about the gifts of the Spirit, the gifts which God blesses people with in order for them to fulfill what God is calling them to fulfill in the world. And how in the church one particular gift was always prized above the others. This was the gift of speaking in tongues, speaking the language of God or the language of the angels. Those who were blessed with it were seen as and saw themselves as holier and better than anyone else because God had blessed them with his language. So Paul points out that it's all well and good to have these gifts from God, but if they stop you being able to talk to and communicate with anyone except God, then how are they any more useful in spreading God's word and bringing others to know God than other gifts which enable people to communicate with others? Paul reminds them that when your pride comes from thinking God blesses you more than anyone else, you're edifying only yourself. Instead, you should be asking God for the gifts which strengthen your community together and thanking God for the gifts of those around you. So let's hear the reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verses 1 to 12. Follow the way of love and eagerly desire gifts of the Spirit, especially prophecy. For anyone who speaks in a tongue does not speak to people, but to God. Indeed, no one understands them. They utter mysteries by the Spirit, but the one who prophesies speaks to the people for their strengthening, encouraging, and comfort. Anyone who speaks in a tongue edifies themselves, but the one who prophesies edifies the church. I would like every one of you to speak in tongues, but I would rather have you prophesy. The one who prophesies is greater than the one who speaks in tongues, unless someone interprets, so that the church may be edified. Now, brothers and sisters, if I come to you and speak in tongues, what good will I be to you unless I bring you some revelation or knowledge or prophecy or word of instruction? Even in the case of lifeless things that make sounds, such as the pipe or the harp, how will anyone know what tune is being played unless there's a distinction in the notes? Again, if the trumpet does not sound a clear call, who will get ready for battle? And so it is with you. Unless you speak intelligible words with your tongue, how will anyone know what you are saying? You will just be speaking into the air. Undoubtedly, there are all sorts of languages in the world, yet none of them is without meaning. If then I do not grasp the meaning of what someone is saying, I'm a foreigner to the speaker, and the speaker is a foreigner to me. So it is with you. Since you are eager for the Spirit, try to excel in those gifts that build up the church. Let us pray. Come worship God in the spirit of holiness. Don't seek to impress him or anyone else with your piety. Strip away your satisfaction and pride and lay your soul bare before him. Almighty God, we praise your greatness and the blessings you shower upon us. Almighty God, we praise your weakness, the way you chose to share our life in Jesus, your Son, born to save us all. Almighty God, we praise your strength, opposing pride and stubborn wills, feeding hungry hearts and lifting humble souls. Almighty God, we praise your name. Father, Son, and Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, you created us to live in harmony and love. But we create divisions, jealousies, conflicts, pride and greed. Make us into people who care for one another in humility, who accept and cherish our differences. Help your church to show the world the power of your love to transcend divisions so that your body may be seen as one without barriers of culture, race, intellect or wealth. Help us to live as members of one body, equally your children, heirs together of your eternal kingdom. Amen. Approachable God, you come to us in the weakness of Christ, as a child upon a lap, and as a man upon the cross. From you there is no hiding place in religious form or devotional exercise. We confess to you and to each other that we embroider your purposes with our own vanities and place burdens of duty upon each other which are not of your making. Wipe from our eyes the mists of self-importance and worth, that we might know and enjoy the tender strength of your persisting purpose in the world. Grant to us the wits that enables us to treasure the past, live full-heartedly in the present, and joyfully embrace the future as your unknown gift. Make us to know the rising of your forgiveness within and among us. Amen. God of all truth and integrity, may those in the shadow of despair be blessed with the light of hope. May those in the shadow of exhaustion be blessed with the light of rest. May those in the shadow of slavery be blessed with the light of empowerment. May those in the shadow of loneliness be blessed with the light of companionship. May those in the shadow of grief be blessed with the light of comfort. And may all your people, tempted by the shadows of pride, be blessed with the light of humility. Amen. So may we let go of pride and pretense, embracing our strengths and accepting our weaknesses. And may God bless, sustain and empower us wherever we are and whatever we are called on to do. Amen. And our final prayer is the song, the UK Blessing, sung by churches across the entirety of the United Kingdom and recorded in the early days of COVID.
Upon you and be gracious to you.
The Lord turn his face toward you
and give you peace.
From heaven, this isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children.